very much like AP.
It just sort of reminds you how difficult this conference is, because you know you're watching all the highlight reels and all the teams that have had great success. You know, I mean, we've won a national championship. James Madison's won a national championship. Richmond's won a national championship. Villanova's won a national championship, and it's all popping up on the screen. The great year Towson had last year. The great year Old Dominion had last year. And what you realize is that it's a long road in front of you. But it's exciting. I like the team we have coming back. I think we could be very special on defense. And offensively, I think there's enough pieces of the puzzle that we can be fine. So you get the juices rolling and you get excited to get back at it. And the kids come in about a week or so and we're starting to start training camp. Oh, it means nothing. I mean, you know, there's been years that Villanova's been ranked last in the league and they've won the conference championship. And it, you know, the year we won the national championship, we were 6-6 the year before that. I don't think people had us number one in the conference, and we won a national championship and go 15-1. So, yeah, the ranking means nothing to me. You know, I didn't even know until you said something to me. That's how interested I was in it. It's a great conference. We have great leadership. I think this is as well coached a conference as any conference in America. I have such respect for the coaches in this conference. You know, the University of Delaware is fortunate to be in a conference like this. And so it's fun. I mean, you know, we get a chance to see each other in Hilton Head. We spend about 3 days together there. We play golf together. We have a lot of meetings and talk about each of our programs and what things we want to do in terms of making the conference better. And so there definitely is a collaborative effort in terms of us trying to make this the best conference in America. And so it's good to see everybody. When you look at our player manual, you'll see schedule, and they'll have one game on there, Westchester. The rest of the schedule isn't even listed. The reason is because it doesn't really matter after that. I mean, you got to play that one game. So that's kind of how we approach it, and we need to really come together during training camp and play well versus Westchester for us to continue on for the rest of the season. So that's why it's all about Westchester. Well, I think, you know, the mystery is going to be the offensive line. You know, we got to kind of piece that thing together a little bit. I think there's enough talent there that we should be pretty good. But when you lose four starters, you lose the 98th overall pick, you lose another one that was picked up by an NFL team, so we lose two NFL offensive linemen, it's tough to replace. You know, quarterback's going to be a little bit of a mystery. You know, Trent Hurley's here. I thought he had a nice spring. You know, Timmy Donnelly, you know, was 7-2 as a starter last year. Trevor Sasek, who was a starter going into the season, he's been now cleared to play. So, you know, we're going to have to be pretty creative in terms of making sure that we get all three of those guys reps and we can do a good evaluation and decide who's the best guy for us to lead us into the 2012 campaign. And that's gonna take a lot of work, and it's going to take a little bit of a finesse to work three quarterbacks, because very unusual you have three quarterbacks that you feel could contend for a starting job. Andrew Pierce is one of the... He'll go down as one of the all-time greats in the history of this conference. Paul Wuerlos is an impressive worker as I've ever had in my 20 years as a head coach. You know, Nigel White has been a big-time receiver for us for a long time. You know, Sean Boehner, Roy came on last year and had a phenomenal year, you know, kicking the ball. Travis Hawkins, I thought, really came on at the end of the season and made some big plays. And our challenge for him now is you need to practice and play the same way. And, you know, he didn't have a great spring, but he had a great spring game. And I think he can be special. I think he needs to push himself and to be that special player. So he's also a great returner, too. So it's exciting to have five guys, you said, all spread out. And I think we do have some other players in there that will get that consideration when the season's over. You're going to see great defense. I think some pretty good special teams. And you're going to see an offense that's going to try to find its identity. You know, will we throw the ball 40 times a game or 20 times a game? I don't think we know that yet. And I think that's what this preseason's all about, to figure out who we can be offensively. And we'll be whoever we need to be to win football games. There's no predetermined destination we want to go in terms of amount of times throwing the ball, formations. I want to win football games. I know we have a great defense. I know that we should be good on special teams. So we need to make sure that offense sort of plugs in.